Hello everyone. Today's topic is quick revision of electrochemistry. In this chapter, we will be discussing only the important formulas related for the objectives. In the electrochemistry, first important topic is about conductance. So conductance is nothing but it is the inverse of resistance. And this conductance can also be taken as some constant S into 1 by R. And this resistance is taken as length by area of cross section. Next, after this conductance, we have specific conductance, which is denoted by K, and also, we have a molar conductance, which is denoted by mu. So, in the molar conductance, we have mu is equal to K into 1000 by molarity, and this formula is used to calculate molar conductance, that is when K is given. Here K is called as specific conductance. So this is called as a specific conductance. And this M is nothing but molarity. Whenever the concentration is given in the molarity, then you have to calculate molar conductance. And sometimes he will ask to calculate equivalent conductance. So if you want to calculate equivalent conductance, the formula is same like molar conductance, but this is denoted by lambda. So this is called as capital lambda. We call it as cap. So lambda is equal to K into 1000 by, instead of molarity, we have to take normality. That's all. So here K is same, but here N is nothing but normality. Next, in this, along with this formula, suppose if a question is asked to calculate degree of dissociation, which is nothing but alpha. So alpha is equal to lambda C by lambda naught. So here this lambda C is nothing but this equivalent conductance, which is calculated at given concentration, whereas this lambda naught is nothing but this is calculated at infinite dilution. So lambda naught is at infinite dilution and this is at given concentration. And after this, he will also ask to calculate dissociation constant, that is K. So, K is equal to C into alpha square. So, this is the formula by which we can calculate dissociation constant, that is K is equal to C into alpha square, where this C is nothing but it can be normality or molarity. And this alpha is nothing but this value. So, whatever the value you are getting, you will take this alpha square here to calculate dissociation constant. And from Kolrath's law, we have formula, that is the total conductance of an electrolyte at infinite dilution will be equal to the equivalent conductances of their cation and anion, nothing but sum of cation and anion, or mobilities of cations and anions. So these are the formulas related for conductance, equivalent conductance, molar conductance, and this sixth one is called as Kolrath's law. And by using this Kolrath's law, we can calculate equivalent conductance of weak electrolytes. Next topic is Faraday's laws. So we have two Faraday's laws, that is Faraday's first law and the second law. First law states that The mass of substance deposited dissolved is directly proportional to the quantity of electricity passed through the electrolyte. So I can take this formula as m is proportional to quantity of electricity q, where this q is nothing but current into time. So again, I also take this equation as m is equal to e into q, where this e is constant, electrochemical equivalent, or m is equal to e into c into t. Here you have to take current in amperes and time we have to take in seconds. And this electrochemical equivalent is equal to equivalent weight by Faraday. You can also write this formula as m is equal to e into capital E. Capital E is at equivalent weight by Faraday. And equivalent weight is nothing but atomic weight by valency, which is nothing but A by Z. This is Z, A by Z. We can also write this equation as m is equal to A into C into T by Z into Faraday, where Faraday is having value of 96,500 coulombs. So this is a value of Faraday. So whenever Faraday you are taking, you can directly take this value as F is equal to 96,500 coulombs. So this is about Faraday's first law. And the Faraday's second law is nothing but, it is very simple. When same current is passed through different electrolytes, then their mass will be equal to the equivalent weight E, their equivalent weight, which is nothing but A by Z, that is A by valency. That's all. So I am writing the terms. So here this Q is quantity of electricity. So this is important. C is nothing but it is current. And T is nothing but time. And this capital E is equivalent weight. And this A is nothing but atomic weight. And Z is nothing but valency. So in the questions, mostly he will ask some elements. He will ask to calculate the mass of some copper or aluminium. Then you can remember this atomic weights and valences. So if aluminium plus 3 is given, then I am writing the A by Z values. So atomic weight of aluminium is 27 and valency 3 electrons. So it is, charge is 3. So it is 3. And if copper plus 2 is given, it is 63.5. And you can see the valency, it is equal to 2. And mostly he will ask silver also. Silver Ag plus, which is nothing but 108 by 1. And if hydrogen like H plus or H minus is given, it is 1 by 1. Oxygen minus 2 is given, then it is 16 divided by 2. So 16 is atomic weight, valence is 2. And sometimes he will give chlorine, Cl minus, which is equal to 35.5 divided by 1. So these are some important atomic weights and their valences for Faraday's first law and second law. Next topic is galvanic cell. So it is a cell or it is a device which makes use of spontaneous redox reaction and generates electrical energy. So in this cell contains one cathode and anode, a copper rod placed in copper sulfate solution. It acts as cathode, and a zinc rod placed in ZnSO4 solution will act as anode. And these two are internally connected by salt bridge and externally connected to a voltmeter. And if you see the reaction taking place in this is, there is a reaction at cathode and a reaction at anode. So in the cathode, the copper plus 2 will undergo reduction, that is addition of electrons to form copper, and the reaction at anode. So in the anode, Zn undergoes oxidation, oxidize to Zn plus 2 and 2 electrons. So the overall reaction is taken as this 2 electrons cancel, and we have copper plus 2 plus Zn gives rise to copper plus Zn plus 2. So this is the overall reaction. And here at the cathode, reduction reaction takes place, and at the anode, oxidation reaction takes place. So there is a redox reaction. So by using this redox reaction, this galvanic cell will produce current. Next. After this galvanic cell, if you want to calculate single electrodes, the single electrodes can be calculated by taking the help of Nernst equation. So in the Nernst equation, we can calculate for metals, single electrode of metals or cations. So cations means M, N positive charges. So for this, we can use this formula, that is E is equal to E naught plus 2.303 RT by NF into log C. So from material to material, the formulas may change, but finally you can use this formula for calculation, that is E is equal to E naught plus 0.059 by N into log C. And here this R value is taken as gas constant, and room temperature is taken, and N is, you can use, that is by seeing the reaction, see how many electrons are being used here. So the electrons which is involved here, it is 2. So you can take here it has 2, and this concentration will be provided in the question. In the same way, we can also calculate for non-metals. Or anions. So for the non-metals, negative charges, anions, and directly writing the second formula, we can take E is equal to E naught minus 0.059 by N into log. So this is a formula to calculate single electrode. So here this E is called as single electrode. So this is called as single electrode. And this single electrode will change based on the given concentration and temperature. But mostly he will ask problems at room temperature. So you can use this formula. If temperature is given in different, not room temperature, then you have to take this temperature as the given. So if suppose it is given as some 40 degrees centigrade, so you have to take in Kelvin, that is 40 plus 273. But 99% the problems will be asked only in room temperature. So you can directly use this formula, that is E naught plus and E naught minus with 0.059. And next, this E naught is nothing but this is called as a standard. So this is a standard electrode potential. And these standard electrode potentials, they are constant for every solution. They are calculated at 1 molar concentration, room temperature, and also at this 1 atmosphere pressure. So these values will not change, but the E value will change based on the concentrations. So this is how we calculate single electrodes for metals, that is cations and non-metals anions. And next, after this, we can also find the EMF by using this Nernst equation. So, how to find the EMF means, so you have to calculate single electrodes of oxidation and reduction, and then we have to calculate EMF is equal to E right hand side minus E left hand side. Suppose some reaction is given in this way. So, the galvanic cell can be represented like this, copper plus 2, copper Zn 2, Zn plus 2. This reaction is given. And the concentrations is given as some 1 molarity and 1 molarity. And here the E naught values will be given for zinc and copper. So, for the zinc you have to use this formula. And you have to calculate E value, and then the same way for the copper also you have to use this formula. Why? Means both are cations, you have to use only cations, and then you can calculate E value for zinc and E value for the copper. After calculating this, see here, these two parallel lines is called as salt beds, and this is right hand side and this is left hand side. So to calculate EMF, you take this right hand side value minus this left hand side value. Suppose if you are getting EMF is equal to some 1.1. After calculating this, you are getting EMF as 1.1 volts. So, this is EMF. I will light EMF. So, we are getting EMF as 1.1 volts. Now, by using this EMF, sometimes he will also ask to calculate delta G naught, standard energy. So this delta G naught is equal to, the formula is minus NF EMF. So this formula is very, very important. So here you can calculate this delta G naught. Here N is nothing but the total number of electrons involved in the cell. So in this this is an example for galvanic cell. In the galvanic cell, in the previous topic we have seen two electrons are being involved, so it is minus 2. And Faraday is nothing but 96,500. And if you take this EMF, we got it as 1.1 volts. If you calculate this, we get some value. And that value is nothing but negative, you will be getting negative. And the units of this value, whatever you are getting, it is in joules. I think this is 21,2300 joules. Once again, you check this calculation, I just remember. And you can also take this as minus 212.3 kilojoules. So, I am not confident with these values. Once you can try calculate this and get the answer. So, this is how we get standard energy. And this formula and problem on this type of question is very, very important. So, in the question, he will give the EMF. So, the total cell will be given and he will give the EMF. Or sometimes he will ask to calculate EMF, and he will ask to calculate EMF, and then he will ask to find delta G naught. Then that problems will be given in JEE mains, but not in the NEET. In the NEET, he will just give the EMF and ask to calculate delta G naught. So the total, the Nernst equation is applied, and we have to calculate EMF, and then we have to calculate delta G naught. So all the three steps are involved, means that type of problems will be asked in JEE mains only. In the NEET, either he may ask to calculate single electrode by given concentration, or he will give the EMF and ask to calculate delta G naught. You can also one see the previous year questions, you'll find these type of questions. So all the three concepts will not be given in the NEET, but in the JEE mains there is a chance of asking all the three concepts, and finally he will ask to calculate delta G naught. That's all. So, these are the important formulas for solving problems in electrochemistry, and along with this, once the students also has to revise what is meant by corrosion, and also revise primary and secondary cells. And this primary cell is of two types. We have two types of primary cell. One is a dry cell and another one is a mercury cell. Once go through this theory topics also. And in the secondary cell we have lead accumulator. So see the reactions which are taking place during charging and discharging in this lead accumulator. And along with this also revise the statements of Kolar's law. And also its applications of this Kolar's law and the definitions of molar conductance, equivalent conductance, and once go through a galvanic cell construction and working and practice these formulas and try to solve some problems in the previous year papers. Thank you, and that's all for the day.